Broadcasting out of Albuquerque, New Mexico, you're listening to the Low Blow MMA Boxing Podcast.
Jorge Hernandez with the Low Blow and Southwest Fight News here with Heather Joe Clark. How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Pretty good. December 7th, it'll be the second time you're fighting for XFC.
Third time.
Yep. At XFC 21, correct?
Yep. Yes.
In Nashville. How does it feel to be back with the promotion?
Excellent. You know, they always treat me really good. You know, I didn't have so much luck the first fight. Unfortunately, my eye got swelled up and everything. Even though I was winning, I gotta always add that in, right? But it's a great show, and I'm just blessed to be there.
Yeah, definitely. And it's Nashville. Did you fight in Nashville before?
Yeah, last fight was Nashville. It was Knoxville, Nashville, and now Nashville again.
Yeah, and it was a pretty good performance that you actually had last time.
Yeah.
So how does it feel building off of that momentum?
Oh, it feels great. You know, this fight, I know this girl's gonna be toughest fight yet, and I've been training my butt off with, you know, the best girls and guys and coaches in the world, and I'm going in there to finish the fight and take it to her.
Now, when it comes to women's MMA, recently we had huge news that the UFC will be adding a women's division. I know you're with the XFC right now, but still, I mean, that's got to give you a sense of pride or just...
You know, absolutely. Just, you know, I mean, there's a lot of talk about, you know, Dana White's only going to introduce the 135 weight class, and obviously I'm, you know, debuting my first 115, so it's a little bit higher than what I'm used to, you know, so it could happen down in the future, but like I said, I'm really happy to be where I am with XFC. Also, with that news of the women coming over to the UFC, you know, that leaves Strikeforce kind of in limbo, and maybe the XFC taking over that Showtime spot. So, you know, I only think XFC is going to get better and just grow immensely just over the next year.
What's your relationship been with the promotion so far? I mean, how many more fights do you have left with them?
I have one more fight after this with an unexclusive contract, and we're already talking about, you know, re-signing and everything, and they have some shows that they're going to be doing overseas in 2013, which, you know, that's my dream to fight all over the world, and so I'm looking forward to that.
They're primarily based out of the East Coast. Do you like that, Lena, leaving home and actually going out there? Because for the most part, I mean, you're either based out of LA or here in Albuquerque.
Correct. I would love to fight in California for once, you know, and actually get an MMA fight here. You know, I got that boxing fight, which it was weird. It was like that. I just remember that day, like even driving to the venue, just going like, am I fighting? You know, it just felt weird because I've always had to fight somewhere else. Even though I got Clovis a few times, it still was like I had to drive, and it wasn't, you know, just like leave your house and go to fight. So I don't know if it really bothers me so much, but yeah, I would like to fight locally, you know, if that was possible, or West Coast, or change it up, or, you know, overseas. Yeah, definitely.
Compare, I guess, the state of mind that you have going to a fight that's nearby, let's say that last boxing match.
Right.
As opposed to going out east, where you've actually gone before. I mean,
the difference I can say is I was a lot more relaxed, you know, like being at my own house, sleeping in my own bed. It didn't really feel like a fight. I just felt like a lot less nerves and stuff like that. Whereas, you know, I'm usually at a hotel, I got to find a place to eat, you know, and I have a very specific diet, things that I do. And so it's always that. It's always a challenge, you know, but I'm getting used to it.
Now, December 7th on Access TV. It's a Friday night. Make sure you guys catch her out. Where can people follow you online?
You can go to my Twitter at Heather Joe Clark, and that is Heather J-O Clark, or Hurricane Heather Joe Clark is my Facebook fan page, or just Heather Joe Clark. And then I just started a website that should be up very soon, and that is Hurricane HeatherClark.com.
You're all over the place.
Sure am.
Make sure you catch her December 7th. We'll see you guys.